Hello everyone, welcome to the Clinical Pearl series. Today I'm going to talk about the assessment of liver chemistry test at a glance. So what liver chemistry tests you can look at when you are assessing liver disease? Of course, in addition to the clinical picture. So the first one is the one that markers of hepatocellular injury. The ones that increase when there is a injury to the hepatic cells. These are the AST and ALT, transaminases. Okay, those are increase. The second type of liver chemistry tests are the ones that measure the synthetic function of the liver, which are the albumin, which is made in the liver. So when in liver disease, severe liver disease, chronic liver disease, it goes down. And also the INR, like the measuring the coagulation factor synthesis, because it's when it goes down, INR gets prolonged. And generally we see that in chronic liver disease and hepatic cirrhosis and severe liver dysfunction. Going back to the hepatocellular injury ones, the AST and ALT, the increase with acute hepatocellular injury. With chronic hepatocellular injury, they go down. I'll discuss that in 2 seconds. The third thing is the bilirubin. Bilirubin also, it's the conjugated and unconjugated increases in liver disease and also in cholestasis as well. In cholestasis also, the measures of the cholestatic disease is the ALP, alkaline phosphatase, and GGT, gamma glutaryl transferase. Those are also can increase. So let's look at the pictures. So when you are interpreting the liver chemistry tests, you need to interpret them all as a whole. Okay, you don't need to interpret them in the separate ones. So for example, so in acute hepatocellular injury, think of the hepatic cells as balloons, and these balloons when they pop, they are filled with the enzyme. And when they pop, the enzymes AST and ALT will go out. In cholestasis, the balloons are filled with ALP, and also bilirubin will increase and GGT will increase. Okay, now with chronic liver disease and more injury to the liver cells, there's no more balloons to pop, right? And so the AST and ALT, either normal level or mildly elevated. But the ones that are increased, affected, the one measures of synthetic liver disease, synthetic function of the liver, the albumin will be go down, and also the INR will be prolonged. In cholestatic function, AST and ALT might be mildly elevated, but not highly elevated, might be normal, but the ones that increased bilirubin, GGT, and ALP. Bilirubin also increases in acute hepatocellular injury. Okay, and if you're interested to further reading, there is a chapter in the patient assessment textbook about assessment of liver function. It is a section about the liver chemistry test. Thank you.